Hello friends, welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to take some of the numerical problems on stresses and strains. As we studied the stresses and strains and their values, so whenever there is a force or system of forces are applied onto any body, at that time there is a deformation has been taken place. If the stresses are applied in all the three directions, at that time there is a change in the volume is taken place. If the force applied in only one single direction, at that time there is extension or there is a change in the length is been taken place into this member. So we'll take some of the problems onto these topics. Let us start with the first problem. I will read first of all the problem. A steel block of a size 100 by 75 by 50 mm is subjected to hydrostatic pressure of 180 MPa. Determine the change in the volume if modulus of elasticity E is equal to 210 GPa and mu is the Poisson's ratio is 0.30. As in this problem, the steel block is there and the hydrostatic pressure is applied. So we know the nature of the hydrostatic pressure is compressive type. So means all the three stresses are applied in compressive type of the nature. So you can see in this particular block diagram, the sigma x, sigma y and sigma z. In all the three directions, the stresses are compressive in nature. So, and all the three stresses are equal in magnitude. So, sigma x is equal to sigma y is equal to sigma z. The value is -180. So, this minus sign is taken for the compressive nature type of the stress. So, MPa 180 MPa, which is minus because this block is in compression. So, total volume of this block, you have the all the dimensions, you multiply with this. And you will get the total volume of this block. Modulus of elasticity is given in GPa. You convert this GPa into MPa by multiplying 10 raised to 3. So 210 into 10 raised to 3, it is converted into MPa. And Poisson's ratio is given 0.30. Now, by using generalized Hooke's law. So this Hooke's law in all the three directions, we already derived. So this epsilon x means strain in x direction. So we by using the generalized Hooke's law, so this is the expression. Whenever that is a, if you want to determine the strain in x direction at that time, so this expression is used 1 upon e sigma x minus in other two opposite other two direction there is a opposite type of the nature. If it is that compressive force or stress is applied in x direction, automatically there is a change in the change in the lateral dimension has been taken place into the other two direction. So here is opposite type of the nature is there for the other two direction. So sigma x minus mu sigma y minus mu sigma z. So E value, you put E value here. So sigma x is the minus 180 because there is a compressive sigma x value is there. And automatically the other two directions the value sign will be changed because there is a nature is opposite. So mu 0.30 0.30 into 180 plus, so is plus sign is taken because the nature is for the other two direction there is a nature is opposite direction, so that's why this positive sign is taken. So 0.3 into 180 plus 0.3 into 180 is the same. So if you solve this particular expression, you will get epsilon x value minus 3.428 into 10 raised to minus 4. So this is a strain in only x direction. Though that stresses are applied in all the three directions are same, that's why strain produced in all the three directions are also same. So whatever the strain in x direction, same strain in y direction and same strain in z direction. So all the three strains in all the three directions are same value. So further, if you want to calculate the volumetric strain, so epsilon v is the volumetric strain. So addition of all the strains mean all the three direction strain, you put same value for all the three direction strain, so you will get the total strain. Once we determine the total strain, so our aim is to finding out the change in volume. So we have the expression epsilon v, that is the volumetric strain is equal to change in the volume divided by total volume. So change in the volume is equal to this epsilon v into v. So we have the v means total volume of this block, and epsilon v is we calculated that volumetric strain. So putting this value, we will get that change in the volume. So this is a particular value minus 385.714 is the change in the volume. Next problem, a bar made up of brass having cross section area is 1000 mm square. It's subjected to axial forces as shown in figure. Find the total change in the length of the bar. E is given, modulus of elasticity. So the bar is there, the brass material, and whose cross section area is 1000 throughout the length, and it's subjected to axial forces. So there are different axial forces. It may be a tensile type of the nature and compressive type of the nature. All these are axial forces are applied. So for solving, our job is to finding out the total change in the length of the bar. Because of these tensile and compressive type of the forces are applied, axial forces are applied, we have to find out the total change in the length. So we'll divide this particular bar into three segments. First segment is that start from this particular end. So this is a tensile type and tensile nature force, which is 150 kilonewton. So apply. So though this total bar is in equilibrium, that's why all the tensile forces and compressive type of the forces, if you take the sign convention, so that it is equal to zero. So tensile and compressive, so finally that nature and that because of the equilibrium, that is equal to zero. So that's why this particular bar is in equilibrium. So with this equilibrium, so we just mentioned that forces 150 tensile in opposite direction 150. So because of this, the bar is in equilibrium condition. So this bar is in equilibrium condition. So here it is a 180 is there, which is a compressive in nature. So that's why this is a tensile force 150, and for this particular middle segment 180, so 30 kilonewton force which is acting is a compressive in nature. So this in the middle segment, there is a 30 kilonewton force is acting, it is compressive, and also for the end segment, there is a compressive type of the force is acting onto the third segment. So you divide your total bar into three segments. So like this, you can apply this. And still this total, all the three segments are in equilibrium condition, either compressive or in tensile type of the nature. So total change in the length of the bar, you can use this formula. Delta L AD means AD is the total length of the bar. Delta L is a change in the length. So change in the length for all the three segments here, it is written here, delta L for AB segment, delta plus delta L BC plus delta L CD segment. So if you able to finding out the change in the length in AB segment, BC segment and CD segment, you can take the summation, you will get the total change in the length. So we have the formula delta L change in the length PL divided by AB. So you apply this formula for all the three segments, so you will get the change in the length for every segment. So apply this, P value is known, force is applied, either compressive for the first segment, there is a tensile type of the force is there, that's a positive sign it is taken, and for this other two segment, there is a compressive type of the forces are there, that's why this is a minus sign is it is mentioned here. So you putting all these value PLAE, all these values are given into this, you will get the delta L or total length of the bar. So delta L AD is getting 0.023 mm. Right. So tensile force is there, positive sign is taken, and compressive negative sign is there. So you can also take the opposite in nature, tension and compression. So depending upon that, you can take any sign convention, final value will be same. Next, a steel bar ABCD 4 meter long is subjected to forces as shown in figure. Find the elongation of the bar. Again, the change in the length, elongation means the change in the length, and modulus of elasticity is 200 GPa. So total ABCD 4 meter long bar is there, and the forces are applied here. This total bar is of a varying section is there. So we can divide this total bar into three segment again. The first segment, you can see here, this is first segment, the diameter is given at the center, 15 mm diameter. Middle segment, somewhat higher diameter is there, 20 mm. And the third segment is again 15 mm diameter. So for if you look at the first segment, you just see the forces system. So that is a tensile type of the force is applied. So because of we maintain the equilibrium condition, so tensile is here again in other direction. There is a tensile force, same tensile force is here. That's why this particular segment is in equilibrium condition. Again, for the second, you can see this 15 kilonewton tensile nature of this force, and in opposite direction again 15 kilonewton. So that's why this bar is in this particular segment is in equilibrium condition. And again in the third, there is a again tensile force 25 kilonewton is applied, and both of this direction the tensile type of the force is there. So here the 5 kilonewton is act in the compressive at the center or at the middle segment. It is a compressive type of the natural force is there. That's why the tension plus, if you take the 20 minus 5, that's why 15. The 15 kilonewton is in tensile force is acting onto this particular segment. So very simple problem that cross, first of all the finding out the cross sectional area of this all these three segment, pi by 4 into d square, the diameter of the bar, diameter of the every segment is given, and length is also given, and force is applied, whether it is a tensile type of the force or compressive, all the three segment the tensile force is there. So if you able to finding out this area of cross sectional, then formula is having delta L means a change in the length, total change in the length, addition of all the three, change in the length of all the three segments. So if you put PL divided by E, and you will putting that value of force, length and cross sectional area and modulus of elasticity for all the three segment, you will get the total change in the length. So like this only this formula is used for the change in the length, PL divided by A, this particular formula. So this particular formula is used for every segment, and finding out the change in length for every segment, and take the addition of all the three, you will get the total change, or you can say the total elongation of this bar ABCD. So finally that delta L is the total change or total elongation of this bar is 1.758 is found out. So that's it for today. Thank you. Thank you very much.